It has been 51 years since the first man stepped foot on the moon, when Apollo 11 successfully landed on the lunar surface on July 16, 1969. It was at this moment when Neil Armstrong uttered those famous lines and changed the history of mankind forever. It was the first major breakthrough in space exploration for mankind. And from that moment onwards, the space industry has constantly evolved, with many countries and organizations becoming a part of the new space race that has started in this new decade. This new race also has instilled, which also is a major contributing factor for the growth of the space industry. A similar situation like this was during the Cold War, when the first space race had started. So how will the future of space look like in the coming future? Who will be the most advanced organizations in the space industry? Today in this video, we will look at how the future of space would be like. So sit back and relax and enjoy the video until the end. The evolution of the space industry and the start of the space race was mainly because of geopolitics between the 1960s and the 1970s. It was undoubtedly the golden era of the space industry, and the Cold War between the United States and the USSR was the fuel. But this time, the space race is distinct. We have to ask a lot of questions to know how the future of space would be like. Until now, only 571 people have been in space. During the Cold War, people were excited about this new technology, space battle, which also encouraged NASA, and soon it could land people on Mars. But since 1972, no man has ever been to the moon, and the excitement of people also diminished. In this new era of space, NASA and many other organizations now plan to send astronauts back to the moon. Today, this space race is unique. It's not only about NASA's decisions. It's about Russia's decision, India's decision, China's decision, and many other countries and private organizations too. It's a much more diverse future. With the falling costs, new technologies in other nations such as China and India entering the landscape, the space will look very different. The pace of advancement is going to explode, with a lot of new space companies emerging, which provides a booming space industry. We already have printing companies in space which have printed on the ISS, and soon many others will follow, along with companies that will provide tourism, better communication in space, and maybe mineral exploration in the future. There might even be more different companies than what we think now. So let's take a close look at each organization up close. Currently, the space industry has had a relatively narrow spectrum of missions, mainly focused on sending satellites used for communication broadcasting and navigation, like the Global Positioning System, or GPS, by the United States. The space industry in the 1960s and 70s depended on mainly the two major superpowers in the Cold War, the USA and the USSR. NASA emerged as the major superpower in space at the end of the Cold War. So let's look at the missions and indications of future missions by NASA. NASA is the most influential space agency in the world and the utmost authority on space, as it was the first major superpower in the space industry and has even maintained it today. NASA is very transparent about its plans and missions. NASA had a budget of about $21 billion in 2020. Out of these, they will use about $11 billion for major space campaigns, like the Space Launch System, SLS, Lunar Gateway, and the Lunar Lander. NASA has the most variety of missions planned in the future, which we can see on their website, which has all the current and future missions listed. We will leave a link down in the description, and you can see NASA's missions yourself. Many of NASA's missions are research projects to validate the usage of certain technology for safe manned missions in space. NASA wanted to send humans back to the moon after the last Apollo mission in 1972, and so it has announced its Artemis project, which plans to send humans to the moon by 2024. NASA plans to do so with the use of the Lunar Platform Gateway, which is somewhat like ISS 2.0. This international project is a moon orbiting station to serve as the staging point for robotic and crewed missions to the lunar surface and beyond. The SLS, which is a new launch vehicle being developed by NASA, will take astronauts and dock with the gateway, which would orbit the moon. At this point, a part of the crew will stay on the station, while others will descend onto the lunar surface for experiments and research projects. Also, as it is an international project, a lot of other nations, including Europe, India, Japan, Russia, and other nations, will use this for their missions. In this new space race, there are new forces that will also help define the future of space. The best example would be new countries like China and India that are entering this new space race. Let's talk about another very influential country in space technology, China. The Chinese Space Agency has made major strides in recent years, and it's on its way to catch up with NASA and Russia. The key advantage of China is its struggle for recognition and its long-term planning of space missions. China will use this to showcase its strength to get recognized as a technologically advanced nation. In the past couple of decades, the Chinese have launched hundreds of rockets from their Long March series of launchers, which is a major component of the Chinese space program now. China also has plans for its lunar exploration program called Chang'e, after the Chinese moon goddess. China has landed its lunar probes Chang'e 3 and 4 on the moon. Chang'e 4 became the first lander to land on the far side of the moon and return some spectacular photographs. Chang'e 5, which is expected to launch this December, is planning to travel to the surface of the moon and return surface samples to Earth for the first time since the Soviet Union's Luna program in the early 1970s. China is also a technocratic nation, which means its leaders are mostly engineers, including the president, and they understand the importance of investment in research and development. China is already planning to get its aerospace industry under the Made in China 2025 plan. China would mainly focus on the satellite missions for improving communications and security. Also, the second thing they want to do is manned space flights. Deep space flights would not be much of a priority for China, as they probably just want to be recognizable. They are already working on their reusable rocket to make their missions economically viable. The Chinese space program has the highest funding after NASA. Russia and India will also play a powerful role in the space industry and its future. India has already made its RLV, or the reusable launch vehicle, which is a reusable rocket along with the PSLV, which is a competitive vehicle in sending commercial payloads into space. India's ISRO is mainly known for its ability to cut costs and complete missions. The Mangalyaan is a space probe sent successfully by India to Mars, making it the third country to do so, and also at a cost of only $60 million, which is half of the budget of the Hollywood movie Gravity. India is similar to SpaceX in their launch vehicle technologies and their mission to lower the cost of space missions without affecting the performance. India has plans to launch the second Mars orbiter and a lunar lander on the moon. It plans to complete its first manned missions to space in 2021. Russia, one of the first competitors of the space race, continues to advance in the space industry. Soyuz will continue to be a powerhouse for manned missions. The robotic Luna 25 will be the first Russian or Soviet moon mission since 1976. Russia's Roscosmos Space Agency aims to launch the Luna 25 moon lander in October of 2021. Lastly, private companies will play an important role in this new space race. As space costs have fallen over the past few decades, and it is cheaper than ever to reach beyond Earth's orbit and explore new frontiers. Between 1958 and 2009, almost all spending in space was performed exclusively by governments and mainly by NASA. Since 2009, the private investment in space travel and technology has soared. They now make up a major part of the space industry. The private sector is mainly driven by three major companies: SpaceX, which is headed by Elon Musk, Blue Origin by Jeff Bezos, and Virgin Atlantic by Richard Branson, which mainly focuses on suborbital flights for tourists. One major benefit that the private sector provides is a dramatic increase in efficiency without compromising the safety. It is estimated that the development of Falcon rockets would have cost NASA about $4 billion. But for SpaceX, however, it only cost about one-tenth of this. These companies mainly aim for commercial business by launching commercial satellites for communication, such as the Starlink satellites by SpaceX, and by providing space tourism. We expect this next year both Virgin Atlantic and Blue Origin to fly passengers on suborbital excursions, offering both the thrill of weightlessness and an unparalleled view of the Earth from near heaven above. SpaceX has even taken a down payment from a Japanese fashion model to take a free return trajectory trip around the moon as early as 2023. SpaceX also has become the first private company to send astronauts to space and plans to send humans to Mars by 2025. The private companies, however, will continue to rely on the state agencies for funding, and the state agencies will rely on private companies for fast and reliable innovation. This trend will be visible to us in the coming decades as private companies lower the cost and increase the efficiency too. In the coming years, there will be many scientific breakthroughs. Some of these ideas are being planned currently, just like reusability of rockets. Scientists think that the asteroid belt in Mars could change the economics of the space missions. The endless resources in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter could help in setting up a self-sustaining Martian base. At the moment, with companies like SpaceX and others who are working on bringing down the cost of space transportation, we'll try to implement this idea. Another idea is of solar power on the moon. It could be an interesting alternative to solve the energy problems on Earth. This technology is actually called the LSP technology. Many organizations believe that the LSP could be a great idea. They plan to build a lunar ring that circles the entire moon, and half the part will be lit at any time of the year. The energy then will be beamed back to the Earth for consumption. It is believed to be cheaper than the solar power on Earth because of better weather. There are no clouds on the moon, obviously. Like this, there are many advanced technologies that might develop in our space industry. Today, many experiments are being carried out in zero gravity, and they are only possible in space and carried out on the ISS. There will be many private organizations that will bid on the future technologies in the space industry, which will be very critical for mankind. However, in the future, we will face a very important concern of space debris. Today, already companies like SpaceX plan to send about 12,000 Starlink satellites into orbit and many other commercial ones. All organizations, both private and government, continue to send satellites for communication and security purposes, but it's creating a lot of space debris. NASA already tracks more than 500,000 pieces of space junk in orbit around the Earth, with objects reaching velocities of over 27,000 kilometers per hour. Even an object as small as a marble presents a dangerous threat. What's worse is that this has been exacerbated even more by the advent of anti-satellite missile technology. The first anti-satellite test of its kind was performed by China in 2007, and is estimated that it alone increased the amount of trackable space debris by 25%. This presents a real problem known to astronomers as the Kessler syndrome, one in which the density of objects orbiting the Earth is high enough that the collisions begin to cascade, creating a domino effect and producing more and more space debris. This makes the low Earth orbit unreachable. So with advanced technology comes more problems, but soon there will be solutions from this too, or at least we hope that. So what do you think the future of our space would look like? Who would be the most advanced and dominating organization in the coming future? Will we have vacations in space? Let us know your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell notification to remain notified of more exciting videos like this. Thanks.